Toyota fans have been energetically anticipating the arrival of the Supra nameplate since essentially the day after creation stopped in 2002. Presented in 1978, Supra developed over those decades from an unassuming alternatives bundle on the Celica to an all-out games vehicle. The model's last emphasis, the MKV 80 Supra, was so every now and again situated in verse different high-dollar Italian exotics through the 1990s that it earned legend status among the tuner swarm. The 326 drive from its 3.0-liter twin-turbocharged inline-six motor was minimal in excess of a beginning stage. The MKV left in 2002, yet it never truly left the awareness of those with a tendency toward the import side of the presentation range. Regardless of whether it was the incredibly stickered legend vehicle from the Fast and the Furious or the fairly more elegantly liveried Castrol Tom's Supra GT in Gran Turismo, the Supra. Indeed, it satisfied its name. Presently, over 15 years after the fact, it's back. Indeed, okay, it's practically back. The new Toyota Supra's turning out gathering occurred in January at the Detroit Auto Show, and it will enter creation for the 2020 model year. That is as yet far off, however I've quite recently had my first go in the driver's seat around a model that is said to be 95% complete. Numerous things transformed from the presentation of the A40 Celica Supra in 1978 as far as possible of the line for the epic twin-turbo MKV 80 Supra in 2002. This new Supra gets from that point, conveying forward a couple of that vehicle's increasingly outstanding characterizing qualities. The first is the general drivetrain design, motor in advanced turning wheels at the back. That proceeds with the new A90 Supra. Its motor, as well, gets the last known point of interest, a turbocharged, 3.0-liter inline-six, much the same as in the past. Nonetheless, expect more power this time around. What amount more? Toyota isn't stating right now, then again, actually it'll be in excess of 300 ponies worth. In light of my time in the seat and some snappy bot dyno estimations, I'd state we're north of 350. In any case, once more, explicit numbers stay to be seen. No numbers yet on the weight, either. Toyota said the vehicle will be under 1,500 kilograms, or around 3,300 pounds. That is not actually light, however what's intriguing is the manner by which the new Supra conveys its weight. At the Supra dispatch occasion, Assistant Chief Engineer Masayuki Kai was pleased to bring up that the vehicle's focal point of gravity is really lower than that of the Toyota 86, a vehicle worked around a level 4 motor explicitly intended to bring down the cog. That the Supra goes even lower with an upstanding, inline 6 is noteworthy. Kai and group likewise invested a considerable amount of energy discussing the proportion between the wheelbase, powerful length, of a vehicle and its track width. While no definite figures were given, the Supra's proportion N is under 1.6, which again is all the more square, and hypothetically more adjusted, than the 86, which is obviously an amazingly agile machine. Notwithstanding, with the Toyota 86 hitting the scales at around 2,800 pounds, maybe as much as 500, not exactly the new Supra, don't anticipate much in the method for comparative driving elements. What's more, don't anticipate that the Supra should look a lot of anything like its forerunners, either. While it's hard to truly figure out the thing with that insane camo covering, unmistakably the articulated nose and ducktail spoiler will make for a particular methodology. I'll retain judgment until I see one without the trippy illustrations, however I wanted to go along one disastrous plan detail: all the plastic work vents you find in the bumpers and in the entryways are strong. They're only there for looks,